Hello. In this video, I'm going to talk about installing some SSDs on a Synology DS918 Plus NAS. And this is my latest video in a series on the Synology NAS. And I'll put a link in the description to my playlist there. And so I did a setup of it. I've installed hard drives. I did a memory upgrade in it. So now the next step, I'm going to put in some SSDs for cache. So right now I'm in the interface. I want to show you where you can access that in the interface. If you go to the storage manager in the interface and you click on SSD cache down here at the bottom, it'll say no available SSDs to create caches. And then you can click on this SSD cache advisor and you can hit next down here at the bottom and it'll say it's going to take a while to calculate. You hit yes and this will run and it will tell you how big to make your cache. But on this system, it says here no SSD cache is created on volume 1. However, the memory on your disk station is full, so it is not possible to create SSD caches. So I found a bug and I've seen this documented online. I upgraded this NAS to 16 gigabytes of RAM. And when you do that, this cache advisor doesn't seem to work correctly. It says your RAM is full, and I don't know why. I did test. I took out one of my memory chips, so I only had 8 gigabyte of RAM, and I ran this, and it said it recommended 209 gigabytes of cache. So keep that in mind if you did the upgrade to 16 gigabytes, that this may not work properly. So I'll close that down, and the first step is to shut down the NAS. And I'll go up to my little profile icon here, and I'll just say shut down. And do I want to shut down? Yes. And the disk station will beep, and lights will go off, and then I'll meet you at my workbench, and we'll swap this out.
Okay, so I'm at my workbench. I have the DS918 Plus here. And the drive I'm putting in are the Samsung M.2 NVMe SSD. It's the 960 EVO. I'll put a link in the description to these on Amazon, and it's my Amazon affiliate account. And if this video helps you out, I'd appreciate it if you'd use that link. It helps me out a little bit. It doesn't cost you anything extra, and it kind of offsets the my effort for making these videos. So to put these in the system, what we'll do is we'll turn it over and we'll pop these tabs off here. Okay, and these are where the two drives go. We'll open the box here. So these things are just super, super tiny. So while I'm putting these in, I'll explain a little bit about how this cache works. It looks like there's a instruction booklet here. If you put in one of these chips, you can do read caching on the system. If you put two in, you can do write caching also. So stick that in, press it down and it clips in. Do the second one. There we go. Then I'll replace the covers here. And that's all ready to go. I'll go plug this back in and we'll get back on the interface and configure it.
Okay, I have the machine all plugged in. I'm back to the interface. Okay, so we have the dual SSDs installed. I'm back in the interface now. And before I set up caching, I want to do a couple tests. I don't know if these tests will show much because it could take a while for the cache to be initiated, but what I've done is I've created about a 500 megabyte random file using this command, and I'm going to copy it to the server, and I'm going to type in time, which will time it, and then copy, and then the name of the file, and then I'll put the share on there, and this will copy it to the share and tell us how long it will take. Okay, so that said 7.9 seconds. And I'm going to run this again, And I'm probably cutting the video or I'm copying it so you don't have to wait through the 8 seconds. Okay, so it seems to be, take about 7.9 to 8.2, 8.4 seconds. So now I'll try another test and I'll copy it from the server to my local directory. Okay, so it looks like we're getting 7.2 seconds, 7.5 seconds. There's a couple runs there. I'll set this aside. We'll set up the cache and we'll rerun that test and see if there's any difference. And like I say, it'll be hard to tell until we get it done if it's going to make much of a difference. But so to set up the cache, we log into our disk station manager here, and then we want to go to storage manager. You may need to go up here to get to it. I've added it to my desktop, so I'll open up storage manager. And then I'll go down here to SSD cache, and I'll hit create. And it'll say we can create read-write cache or read-only. And I want to do read-write cache. I'll hit next. I'll choose my two SSDs. I'll hit next. I want RAID 1. And RAID 1, if you're not familiar with it, that's mirroring. So it will read and write everything to both drives. So the drives will mirror each other. And I will choose the max size. Here we can say skip sequential I/O. It says read and write sequential data directly from two drives to improve speed and performance, as well as to increase the lifespan of SSDs. Please enable this function if you are using backup applications. So this, for streaming, I think if this were streaming like a movie from the box, it will skip the SSDs, because when you stream a movie, you're not going to want to read that back again. You're only going to read it once. Now, as far as the lifespan of SSDs, these SSDs have such a long life on them. I don't know that it would make a big difference in the, small office, home office application. So it is telling us it's going to remove the data from the SSDs. I'll say OK. I'll hit OK here. And now it is mounting the cache and creating the cache. I don't know if we can open this yet. We can. OK. So we can watch here as it creates the SSD cache. Okay, the cache is created, so it says SSD cache 1, normal. One thing I want to mention here is that we put in two SSD cards into the NAS, and as far as I know, the only thing you can use them for is SSD cache. You can't create a volume with those. I tried it myself and could not do it, and I searched online, and it doesn't appear that you can take that SSD, the M.2 cards, and make just a volume with it. You can do that with regular SATA SSDs. So we have our cache here. We'll go back into our terminal. So I have read and write here. Copy my command over. And we'll just do some tests and see if we get anything different on the writes and reads. I should mention that I have an SSD in this Mac I'm using, and I'm connecting to the NAS through a switch on a gigabit network. So it looks like we had a slight increase there. I'll run this a couple more times. Okay, so if we look here, we had 7.9 seconds before and after the cache. Then on the second time we did it, we had 8.2 seconds on the before and after the cache. And then we had 8.4 seconds and 7.5, and then 7.9 and 7.2. So it does look like it's slightly faster. Now, it's hard to say if that's due to the cache or some other thing on the system. So let's try some read tests here and see what we get. Okay, so our read tests show some interesting numbers here. The first time we did a read from this, it was slightly faster. And then the second two times, it was a little bit slower than before the cache. So it's hard to say if the cache is slowing it down or not. I have tried this cache prior, and it was running for a couple days, and this 1% here went up to 35%. So according to the system, it was using cache. But, you know, will it speed up your NAS a lot? You know, with just these simple file tests, it's not showing that it's going to speed it up a lot. So I will be running virtual machines on this disk station, and that will likely utilize the SSD cache quite a bit. So, you know, that's something to take into account. But, you know, I'm not going to make a decision for anyone watching this as to if they should put cache in theirs or not. This super simple test doesn't show a lot. And I've done tests like this in the past using a Blackmagic speed test, and it has kind of similar results as this command line test I'm running. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like. I'll put a link down below to my playlist with other Synology videos and such. So, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I would love if you do that. So thanks for watching. Bye.